Welcome back to another episode of Halo Wars. Cool. Today I'm bringing you a 3-3 challenge game between myself and Snizzy. You are going to be hearing Steak in the background because this is from his perspective. He was the one streaming the night when we were playing this challenge. On our team, you're going to have QB Ghost playing as the Arbiter, myself playing as the Brute, and Steak playing as the Anders. On the opposite team, you're going to have Topher playing as the Arbiter, Filthy Rocker playing as the Brute, and Snizzy playing as the Anders. Anyway, I'm going to have a lot to talk about today, so let's get right into it. Here about a month ago, we had Orca Sailor Wars 3v3 tournament. We had four teams enter in. I ended up being with Andrew and Rupe, and I think we did all right. We ended up losing in the final to Topher, Fusion, and Kibbles. I recommend that you go and watch all the games on Orca's YouTube channel. Originally, our team was going to be myself, Rupe, and Smootube. And then Snizzy and QB, they were looking for a teammate. So I straight up told Smootube, look, man, I think I want you to pick whoever you want to be with. If you think that you got a better chance to win the tournament with Snizzy and QB, then by all means, go play with them. We'll just get somebody else and we'll try our best. And he ended up choosing that team. Unfortunately for them, on the day of the tournament, Snizzy, he couldn't play and he didn't like say that in advance. So they ended up playing with Patrick instead. On the first day of the tournament, I believe we beat Tiny Shoes team. And then we lost to the other two teams, but we ended up making it to the losers final the next day, and we started doing a lot better, and we actually won the losers final. But then it got late, so Rupert couldn't play, so we ended up playing the final the next day, and unfortunately it didn't work out for us. We ended up losing 5-2. But and to be honest, I was very happy, like looking back at it, like considering all the facts and everything, like I think we did pretty good. So I'm not, I mean, I always hate losing to them fucking assholes, and Orca kind of bent the rules a little bit for them too. But it is what it is, you know, I ain't gonna complain, and I'm happy with our performance overall. Anyway, I digress. As you can see, I cleared the jackals with my chopper on our side, and QB Ghost is going to have his ghost on their side, and I'm going to see that their brute is actually going to swing all the way around and hit my expo. So I'm just going to build brutes and get Citadel as fast as possible on my expo, which is going to slow down my first couple of brutes. But he is not going to be on my base for like until like 30 seconds after I get to what's going to be the Arbiter's Expo this game. As you can see, they were trying to bully Steak, and Steak, honestly, he did pretty good. He had to build, what, one extra Marine? I really don't think that's a big deal at all. Steak went Reactor 4th on his main base and Barrack 2nd on his Expo, which is what you should do. I tested out Reactor 5th on my main and Barrack 2nd, and that could work too. And the one advantage of that is like you're gonna have a little bit of extra money to queue up a couple of flamethrowers in case they try to cheese your expo. Mostly that's what that would be for. So if you know that they're for sure gonna try and cheese your expo, well, that is something that you could try and just pump out a few flamethrowers, because nothing stops a goddamn fucking RB cheese like three flamethrowers in front of the fucking expo. I learned that shit from La Perla. He's the one that told me that. As you can see, Topher is going to push up his fucking Arbiter, and he is going to cheese Steak right away. I have two Brutes standing in front of his expo, but like they're not really going to do much. But Steak is going to come on in, and he is going to de-bomb this Arbiter. And he is going to save his expo, but honestly, it was not the best D-bomb. But, I mean, what matters here is he is going to save his base, whereas Snizzy is going to end up losing his.
Winning.
Anyway, here on your screen, you're gonna see all the challenges that have been played since my last video. The tier list is fully updated as of right now. I appreciate everybody that's been playing their challenges consistently, like Tiny Shoe and Dilbert. Getting some of these people to play their challenges has been really hard. For example, Phantom challenged me, and like I've been ready to play him every day, and he's just been waiting and holding off and saying like I got 2 weeks to play you, so I don't want to do it right now. The 2 weeks are there not so you can just wait until the last minute. That's a deadline in case the guy's not there or he wants to take a couple of days to practice, but like not take a whole week. So I might have to think of something for that not to happen anymore, for people to like actually like grow some balls and actually play their challenges, because kind of some bullshit. I made a deal with Phantom that I would give him the rating that he thought he was, as long as he would accept any challenges from anybody. So as of right now, he's supposed to accept any challenges. I cannot challenge him because I'm rated higher than him, but I suggest you people go challenge him. He's easy money. Tetloach made his own tier list. He's still working on it, but his works a little bit different. Supposedly, if you're the best player on any playlist, you're a 99. And he made me overall rated number 5th on his list, which I honestly do not think I'm the 5th best player in the game. I don't believe that. But hey, I'll take it. He thinks I'm the 5th best player. I know he was arguing with Topher because Topher wants to be the best player even though he doesn't play once. And I would say as of right now, yeah, Topher is probably the best 3s and 2s player. But you can't be the best player overall if you don't play once. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't just neglect what I would say is probably the most important playlist and then claim to be the best. I'm sorry, but that's just not how it works. So I think Tetloach is right in doing that. Anyway, let's talk a little bit about the game. As you can see, Filthy has been stopped, and Topher's Arbiter actually recall. He got the healing upgrade, and he was raging my Brute Ball. And like the hall on their side is kind of getting out of control. We could have actually killed the Arbiter because he was like red bar if Steak would have came down. When Steak healed his Expo, he had a couple of weak Warhogs that he could have healed with the Expo, but I mean, I think Steak was a little stressed out this game, because here a little bit later, you're gonna see him thinking that he has a D-bomb and getting all fucked up. However, we've been fucking up Snizzy really good. I've been vortexing Warhogs coming out of his base. Remember in the beginning he lost his Expo, so Snizz is actually hurting a lot. So right here, we're going to try and stop this haul. We're going to triple team on it. I'm going to recall with my upgraded Vortex. I'm going to Vortex. QB is going to rage it down, and Stick is going to come in. As you can see, Filthy's Vortex is not upgraded, so it really doesn't do that much to Goss Warhogs. If you're going to fight Goss Warhogs with a haul, you need an upgraded Vortex. Like, that's like the whole point of going haul is to fight Warhogs. Is to have an upgraded Vortex. If you don't, like, it's a waste. So right here, as you can see, we're gonna get this shit off my base. Topher lost his Expo, I lost my Expo, and Steak lost his main. Snizzy lost his Expo, and right here, Steak is gonna go defend his Expo, and I asked him if he had the D-bomb because the Arby showed up, and he said he had the D-bomb. So he's just gonna go keep pushing all the way to the Brute's Expo. QB Ghost is gonna be rage running all the way up to Snizzy's Expo and taking them out yet again. So Snizzy is on one base and a base with like weak pads and half health. So yeah, there you go. The only problem we have right now is that their Brute is out of control. He's been untouched, 2 Expos. However, Snizzy is gonna be so broke that he's not even gonna heal him. Now remember, Steak said he did have a D-bomb. Here's some proof.
Yeah, I have a D-bomb. Yeah, I have a D-bomb.
Yeah, I haven't even.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Everybody knows you never go full retard. You went full retard, man. Never go full retard.
Anyway, as bad as that was, we're actually not looking that bad. This brute pushed up with no health because Snizzy, I don't know if he healed something else or he just didn't have money. But we're going to come back and we're going to play defense on this brute at Tell Stake. Okay, well, we're probably not going to be able to defend that expo. But actually, he probably could have because looking back at it, like we were like really close to saving the expo. Because as Snizzy, like I said, he's actually really fucked up. He has like one expo with like two pads, and having Vortex and Warhawks as they come out, so he's really been struggling at getting Warhawks out. We're gonna end up being really close from saving this expo. Snizzy gonna get his Warhawks got again. And Steak probably could have healed his Warhawks on his other base. I mean, at the point, like, he could probably still get back and get some of the heal. And they're just gonna keep pushing. I'm gonna push up to Filthy's main base, and I'm gonna see that for some reason he has his temple on the front of the base. And I'm just gonna pour my haul on that, and I am going to deny the temple before their brute can come out. And it is gonna be at that point that they are going to quit. And I am going to earn my 47 in 3v3. Thank you guys for watching and have a great day. Be good to your families. Peace.